You're watching Brainstorm on ABC 27, presented by Penn State Hershey Medical Center.
I'm in the cancer.
Okay, all right, terrific. Welcome back. We're just continuing to talk with Dr. Jonas Sheehan from Penn State Hershey Medical Center. He is here to answer your questions about brain tumors and brain cancer. We've got doctors in our conference room ready to talk to you about Alzheimer's disease, any questions you may have, and we should show the phone number from time to time just so folks can call in and ask their questions. But we're going to continue to deal with some other issues here. Look, whenever you have a brain tumor, do you know that you have to have an operation, or not necessarily?
No, many patients with brain tumors don't have an operation. Now, they can be definitively treated often with radiation or chemotherapy or a combination of the two. Sometimes an operation is necessary for certain types of tumor. It can be curative. It can be a benefit in terms of quality of life. It can extend survival. So not everyone needs an operation, but many patients benefit from an operation for a variety of reasons.
Now, one of our viewers was on ABC27.com, and she submitted the question that her mother had a brain tumor. Does that make her more likely to have a brain tumor?
We get that question all the time. There are a few rare hereditary syndromes in which brain tumors are common. Those are fairly rare situations. Typically, if a loved one or a family member has a brain tumor, that doesn't increase your risk substantially of having a brain tumor yourself.
Someone else wrote in and said their friend had a brain tumor and decided to go into some sort of experimental, like a clinical trial.
Right.
I mean, do you suggest that? Is that something for a last resort? What do you say about
that? Well, there are a variety of types of clinical trials. Some are only for last resort patients. Some are randomization between two treatments that we think are both very good, and we're trying to find out which is the better of the two. In general, clinical trials are safe. They are federally regulated. And no clinical trial can be conducted without some reasonable security of safety.
Okay. You know, people get headaches. We all know people who have persistent, strong headaches. I mean, how often is that a serious sign?
Headaches can be a problem, but they're rarely from brain tumors.
Okay.
Most patients with brain tumors have a headache associated with a tumor, but very few patients with headaches have a tumor associated with it.
Okay. And again, we just want to remind folks of the phone number. You can call 346-3333, and we're going to show you right now where your phone call goes. Valerie Pritchard standing by with five doctors answering your questions. Val.
That's right, and they're very busy in here. We had audio problems earlier, but I'll tell you, even with those, I was sitting here and the phones kept ringing and ringing. You can see all the doctors are taking calls at this hour. Now, the number that we give you, that 346-3333, will put you in touch with a doctor. Now, some of the questions that come in, we're not going to put your name out there or your personal information about you, but some of the questions we might want to share with our audience just to let you know that, but we will respect your privacy. And again, as you can see, the doctors are busy at this hour. Very few times do I see a phone down. So see, there we go. Phone's picked up again, Alicia. I know we're going to be checking in a little later, and we're going to be introducing you to a family who their daughter had a brain tumor and worked through that. And we're going to be talking about those issues as well. So we'll get back to you in a little bit.
All right, Val, thanks very much. And it's nice to see people calling in. It doesn't surprise me. People concerned about these kinds of issues. We want to run another story now. The research behind brain tumors is constantly changing, and important work is being done right here at home. Amanda Barton tells us about some recent breakthroughs.
Two big discoveries have been made here in the neurosurgery labs at Penn State Hershey Medical Center.
Yeah, we just have to make
leading
sure
the charge, Dr. James Connor. The goal of his team, to find a cure for brain tumors.
And we've been able to find a bit of a magic bullet, if you will, so that we can take cells that we call liposomes. They're really sort of smart little fat cells, and we can put drugs in those smart little fat cells that will kill tumors.
The direct delivery of drugs targets the tumor and minimizes side effects.
The drug is confined just to the tumor cells here. So this is the excitement that we were talking about, that we don't damage the normal healthy cells in the brain.
The other recent discovery, researchers have pinpointed a genetic mutation that could be a risk factor for certain aggressive tumors.
Looks like we've discovered a new drug that by using these tumors and screening a whole range of drugs, we've found a new drug that might be effective against not only these tumors that are resistant, but a broad range of tumors.
All of this means a big advantage for patients. Researchers work closely with brain surgeons to keep them up to date on treatment options. Both teams meet twice a month in a conference room like this to discuss breakthroughs and share information.
the end of the day, we can sit down and they can say, you know, these are the problems we're facing. This is what we need. We need a better target for the tumor cells. We need another drug. You know, what can we do together to move this forward, all aimed at improving patient care.
At Penn State Hershey Medical Center, Amanda Martin for ABC 27.
All right, and still to come tonight, more questions answered and brain cancer survival stories from some very young patients. We'll be right back.
Brainstorm on ABC 27 is presented by Penn State Hershey Medical Center.